Compound VR is a roguelite VR shooter featuring some of the most satisfying gameplay I've ever experienced in a game. It's also tough as nails.
There he is.
God damn it. As a top player on the leaderboard, my older video helping new players didn't seem exactly fitting.
Oops, that was not on purpose. Usually this level always... Yeah.
Compound has a total of 8 areas, 7 of which have 2 iterations per run, totaling into 17 levels you have to fight your way through to take down the evil corporation fittingly named Megacorp. Compound has 12 weapons, being split into 4 categories, those being blue, whose guns have infinite ammo and are easily accessible, purple, which are simple weapons like submachine guns or revolvers, green, which denominates explosive weapons, and orange, usually meaning more out there sci-fi type weapons, like the Sonic Pulse Generator, or SPG, which we'll get more into later. Just as a frame of reference, we're going to be using hard as a difficulty baseline for everything discussed here. As a player, you're fairly weak and presumably unarmored, and as such you have 3 hit points, and lose 1 for every magical sci-fi bullet that comes into contact with you. You can hold a total of 3 guns, 1 in each hand and 1 in a reserve slot that you can swap out at any time. Kinda like Tetris. You clear each floor by eliminating all the enemies on said floor, which is harder than it sounds.
There he is.
God damn it. I mean, if it wasn't, we wouldn't have a video, would we? In Compound, there are 3 categories of enemies: humanoid, robotic, and bosses. Humanoid enemies include the basic grunts, of which there are 6 variations split into 2 categories, those being basic and elite. And the 3 variations are pistol guards, submachine gun guards, and shotgun guards for both categories. Elite guards are significantly faster and more tanky than basic guards and will only shoot you in their preferred ranges, which are based on their guns. Basic guards are slow, weak, and will shoot you the moment they see you, no matter how far. Robotic enemies include drones, of which there are 3, SMG, pistol, and kamikaze, the K4NI or Kani robots, security tanks, and stalkers, of which there are 2, pistol and rail, which denotes sniper. There are 7 bosses in this game, of which there are the Sewer Rat, Booster Bruce, the Accountant, Spider Tank, Dr. Amoral, the Gold Leader, and the final boss, the Helicopter. Compound VR, enemies don't know your exact location at all times. They have to see you or see you kill someone. Usually, this is accompanied by a voice line or sound effect playing.
I hear a tank coming up. Watch it go. Beep, beep, beep.
Stop him!
Stop him! Blah!
Every enemy has a FOV, or field of vision, and the rule of thumb to follow here is that robots can see way better than humans.
Hey, bro. How's work going? Man, I hate guarding this place. Well, I should let you know. Kind of an idiot. Another one? Hey, you seen this guy around anywhere? This guy has been invading us? Hey, I got that for you. How you doing? Damn it.
When you think of good aim in VR, you think it's insanely hard or impossible to achieve. And the truth is, it's really easy to aim well. You're probably aiming like this. Not moving your hands enough and way too eager to shoot. This game is fast-paced and you have to aim at the enemy if you want to live. Don't be afraid to move your hands around more. It feels great and will greatly improve your aim. Speaking of moving around, I see so many people freeze up when they get shot at. And I mean, fair point, you're being held at gunpoint.
We can talk about this, man. We can talk about it.
But bullets have travel time. Noticeably slow travel time. Don't be afraid to move. You'll be surprised at how many situations you can get out of unscathed. While we're on the topic of moving, keep in mind where you're moving to. I know it sounds obvious, but you have to be aware of your surroundings. And I mean in real life, too.
Oh, sick of gun, dude.
Oh! That hurt. I just hit my bed frame with my shin. If you're fighting in an open area, be aware of escape routes or cover to try to funnel enemies into you or just to take a breather and reload your weapons. Which, by the way, unlocking your weapons should be your first priority. The game is a lot easier with access to all of them. And here, we come to the tip for players of any skill level. Target priority. You have to prioritize your targets if you want to succeed in the later levels of Compound, and how you do that can be pretty involved for such a fast-paced game. Target priority has 3.5 factors, the importance of which you decide. Those are the enemy's health, how dangerous they are to you, and positioning, both yours and theirs. That's the half. Let's take an SMG drone for example. Low health, high danger, hard to hit. These are pretty high priority for me, because they dish out insane damage in very little time, while dying to literally anything, which makes them a high threat but not a very tough one. And then we have something like the Elite Shotgun Guard, who's probably your highest priority, because of how quickly they'll be in your face and shooting. And on top of that, they can take a hit or two, which makes them more dangerous. And that's target priority, and it sounds simple, but try doing that when you're trying not to die to this. But why do that when you can do this? Anyway. That's about it. Good luck out there. Thanks to everyone in the Compound Discord for help with the graphics, especially Bevan, the dev of the game, for being such a down-to-earth person and interacting with the community so much. That's all I have for you today. See ya.